OSN, which was the largest Middle East network, Orbit Showtime Network. It offered premium channels, 86 for MENA viewers, was owned by Panther Media Group and the joint venture between Kuwaiti Projects, KIPCO, and Saudi investment Mawarid Group Limited, the largest direct broadcast satellite provider. In 2013, this company was valued at $4.3 billion. Okay. They were so big, and they had speculated that they're going to grow even more bigger. They even rejected a $3.2 billion buyout for a 60% share. Just imagine, they said no for $3.2 billion offer in cash. Okay, cash or whatever. Now they are only worth at $665 million. So that's, I would say, one fourth, one sixth. It's shocking. Huh? It's one eighth. Just imagine, they were offered $3.2 billion. They said no. And today they're valued at $665 million. It's very sad. And what is the reason? Now, here's a question. The main focus should be why a company that was valued at $4.3 billion, why is it today valued at only $665 million? Number one, leadership. They changed the top guys at the top. They brought in fresh blood. And when you bring someone at the top, it always happens, whether it's Petrofac, whether it's any company, once you change the guy at the top, he brings his own goons down below. So what they did is, they have these you know, multinational companies, especially in the Middle East, have this thing for white skin people, people with white passports. And all these guys who come to the Middle East, they come with this big hype and, you know, pink tie, and they look with gel hair, and they talk with, oh, hi, how are you? And, you know, all this impressive jargon. So they bought a lot of people from Europe and the UK, especially the UK. They had no Middle East experience, no track record, and they were paid overhyped salaries, which increased their overheads, and they did their own thing. They bought their own gangs. Number three is they ditched the things that really worked with the Middle East market. They ditched focusing on the low-income spenders. They only wanted high-income spenders. Now, before, they had three buildings in Dubai, Media City, Internet City. I know this because I used to travel to Internet City and Media City. Now they have closed down Dubai Internet City offices. They are planning to reduce it to just one building. It seems OSN employees, they have been facing massive terminations for the last 24 months. This lack of security, and it's a very unpleasant environment to work. As per this report, it says, one of the former employees said, when we go to work, we just don't know whether we are going to have the job or not going to have a job. Many of us don't know if we are going to be called into the room with the HR and be told, I'm sorry, you've lost your job. We don't need you. It's like we're dodging bullets every day. Remember the example I gave you of one of the guys who was working as the top manager in the company? He was called to the HR and they just called him and said, please leave the premises, wait at the reception, and we will let you know what is going on. They'll be like, what's going on? They take your security badge, they literally make you sit at the reception. Imagine you have been working in a company for 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, your whole life, you know everyone like a family. And then all of a sudden they take your security badge, they make you wait at the reception, treat you like an outsider, and terminate you. How does it feel? This is life in the Middle East.